Good morning, good morning. Happy Friday. Happy Friday, happy Friday. I'm gonna stop that. It's a new one I found. Anyways, happy Friday. Oh my gosh. He is always good. I know it's backwards in the camera, but it's okay. That's what my coffee cup says this morning. He is always good, and he's always good. Y'all, it is Friday. I'm gonna need somebody to celebrate. Like, give me some hands up, some confetti, some something. I mean, it is Friday, right? Yeah, it is, okay. Happy Friday. Y'all, we are on day 97. This book is coming to an end so fast, and I don't know if to be excited about finishing 100 days of devotions, or if I'm sad because it's coming to an end, because this devotional book is so good. So good. So look, run out, get you a copy, order it. I don't know what you got to do, but 100 Days to Brave by Anya Thales. And no, I don't get paid for advertising for her. I get no kickback. The only kickback I want to get, well, I don't really want to get, but would be good to see, because nothing comes back to me, but all to God, is that your relationship with the Lord just absolutely grows closer and closer day by day. And if I can be a small part of that, of helping you find a really good devotion to help you stay on that journey, stay on that path with knowing the Lord, that's what it's all about. That would make my heart happy. So yeah, we're on day 97. Jesus is brave. I know yesterday I wanted to say that so bad. So bad, because yesterday's was Jesus was brave. And I'm like, but he is brave. He's still brave today. And but I had peaked it the next day, so I knew that was coming. So I couldn't say it yesterday. And I know some of you are probably thinking the same thing. He was brave. Yes, he was brave, but he is. Jesus is brave. Oh my gosh, he is brave, y'all. And we're about to talk about it, okay? Revelation 19:11 says, "Then I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. The one sitting on it is called Faithful and True." Faithful and True. So if you're watching me live, give me #1. If you're watching the replay, give me #2. And we are going to get going here this morning. So she says, did you just read that verse, or did you hear it? That hasn't happened yet. Let me read it again, that verse. "Then I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. The one sitting on it is called Faithful and True." That's Revelation 19:11. That hasn't happened yet. You realize that, right? Jesus is coming back. He is coming back. Praise God. Not as the baby in a manger. Not as the baby in the humble manger, but as the mighty King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Woo! Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He's not coming back as the baby. He's coming back as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, right? Baby Jesus was brave, right? But baby Jesus was here on a mission to save us from our sin. He's already done that good work. He's already died and resurrected, y'all. He came so we didn't have to make those sacrifices with animals anymore. We didn't have to kill animals to purify us, to forgive for our sins, right? We know that God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die on a cross for us as the sacrificial lamb. He was the ultimate sacrifice for us. That we don't have to go and do those things anymore. When he died on a cross, the veil was torn from top to bottom, right? We read that in the scriptures. Man, the temple that was torn so that all of us has access now to the throne of God. We can pray to Jesus anywhere we are. Hallelujah. We can go straight to him. We don't have to go through priests and other people. We can go straight to the Father now because Jesus died on a cross for us, and that veil was torn that allowed us to go in. And that is something to be excited about on this Friday morning, in case you didn't know. You can be excited about that. But he came and he did that. And remember Jesus praying, you know, Father, let this cup pass from me, but nevertheless, not my will, your will be done. And he was brave. We know that Jesus was brave in that and following the plan that the Father had. That yes, you're going to suffer and you're going to take on the sin of the world and you're going to die on a cross. A perfect man, son of God, right? Whew. And he did that for us. So we could go straight to him and be saved. Oh, God is good, y'all. God is so good, so good. Okay, and I know I just like said a whole lot. Back to what she said. Jesus is still alive and still working for our good today. He is alive, y'all. He is alive. He is alive. He is alive, okay? He is still the humble king who came to the earth, but his mission will be different when he returns. Hallelujah. He's going to come back and judge sin once and for all and destroy the enemy who has made this world such a broken and painful place. See, Jesus wasn't just brave in the past tense. Jesus is brave today. Jesus knows I'm a screw up, and for that, he gave his life. He gave his life. I am so grateful for that salvation. But over and over again, I ask Jesus for forgiveness and rescue, and he always provides them. Man, aren't you thankful today? You would never buy a car that got a flat tire every time you test drove it. And you wouldn't, and you would stop eating at restaurants that repeatedly got your order wrong. And yet Jesus does that for me all the time. Doesn't he do that for us all the time? Whew. He takes a chance on us every day, doesn't he? Oh, she says, I have a flat tire and get his order wrong and sin and everything in between. He takes risk for me. And he takes a risk on me. John 3:16 says it all. God loves you so much that he gave up his own son so that your sin would not be able to separate you from him forever. Praise God. Praise God. God is holy and we are sinners. We were born sinners, right? We're born worldly, right? In sin. But Jesus bridged the gap. Man, his death and resurrection cleared the path for us. Man, I don't know if that makes anybody else excited this morning, but it makes me excited. Man, it makes the Holy Spirit in me is just doing cartwheels and jumping up and down because it's the truth. Man, Jesus dying on a cross, and we're about to celebrate Easter here in just a few short weeks. We're going to be celebrating Jesus' resurrection, that he conquered death, hell, and the grave. He went down. He took the keys back, right? He took them back for us. Guys, man, it's huge. It's part of the foundation of our belief, our Christianity, and following Jesus Christ and knowing that he died and he rose again. Praise God. Praise God. His resurrection proved that he is God, that he has the power to overcome death, and that his forgiveness of our sins was real. It was real. He deeply loves you and deeply knows you and is doing the hard work of forgiving and forgiving and forgiving again and again. Jesus is brave, and he made you to be brave too. Man, you know what? I thought about that and I'm like, Lord, you love us so much, so much. You want to walk with us. You want to talk to us. You want to spend your days with us. You want to spend every moment with us. If we would just be brave enough to want to do that too, to say, okay, God, if you're willing to take a risk on me and you know me, you know my faults, you know the things that I've done in my past, those things that I don't want anybody else to know, maybe. Maybe it's those just things I'm so ashamed of, and I feel like you wouldn't really want to be with me. But he does. He does. He loves us so much. He wants to be with us. And we have to be brave in that same sense and say, you know what? If he's willing to die for me, he was willing to die for me. He's willing to walk with me. He wants me. Then I'm willing to lay it all down for him too. I'm going to do it. I'm going to be brave. I'm going to thank him for dying on a cross for me. I'm going to thank him for raising again. I'm going to thank him for loving me in my mess. I'm going to thank him for wanting me dirty and unclean, that he would pick me up and wash me clean and make me new, turn me around, set me on the right path, and walk this thing out with me called life. I'm willing to do that today. I want to do that today. And I'm going to change. I'm going to turn directions. And instead of walking away from God and walking away from Jesus, I'm going to turn and walk with him. I'm going to hold his hand. I'm going to follow him. I'm going to let him illuminate my path. He's going to light it up for me. Man, he's going to speak the truth to me. It's going to set me free. Hallelujah. Praise God, somebody. Right? So good today. Jesus is brave. You can be brave too. You can be brave too. He's brave. He did the things. Man, and he loves us. He created us. He knows us. He knows that we are not perfect people and that we make mistakes, and yet he loves us anyway. Man, he loves us. So love on Jesus today. Man, pour it back on him today. Play that worship music today. Pray. Spend time in his presence today. Speak to him today. Tell him how wonderful he is today. Pour your love out on the one who died for you today. Do it. I'm telling you, it will fill your heart. Man, that peace will just come over you and rush over you when you really think about all that God is, all who Jesus is, and what he's done for you in your life. Man, it's a good thing. It's a great thing. It's an awesome thing, right? All right, so her be brave thing today, she says to thank Jesus that he takes a risk on you over and over again. He does. Thank him that the grave did not hold him down and that he is a risen and living king. Thank him that every day we come to him and we ask, God, forgive me for my sins. He keeps forgiving us. Whew. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that your love is just never ending. It's never failing, right? It's unconditional. That we can come to you over and over and over again and you forgive us every time and you still pour your love out on us. Lord, help us to do the same. Help us to forgive a brother or a sister. Help us to love and worship you and honor you and love others, right? To be brave, we can do it, guys. Y'all have a wonderful Friday. Have a wonderful weekend. Be blessed. If you have nothing, a little plug here, shameless plug for my church for tomorrow. We are having an Easter extravaganza at Unity Outreach Church at the Gloverville Park on Pine Street from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock. Please come. Free food. There's going to be candy for kids, eggs for them to get, a bunny. There's going to be music, drama, so many good things. A prayer tent. Guys, we're going to pray with you. So come out. Let's have a good time. And man, just have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. And I will see y'all Monday on the EMJ Daily. Bye, guys.